Shalom, first and foremost, I'm going to give all praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Raka, Kadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Peace, love, and salutation to all you occupants pushing this truth and truth with sincerity. So this is Lamentations chapter 4 and verses 17. Bear with me for a sec. Lamentations 4 and 17. As for us, our eyes are yet failed for our vain help. In our watching, we have watched for a nation that could not save us. They hunt our steps, that we cannot go in our streets. Our end is near, our days are fulfilled, for our end is come. And we're here in America, where our people are still hoping and wishing for their oppressors to make some kind of change and make them feel better. Verse 19. And you're still the prey here in America. It doesn't matter how many times you vote, or how many times you express your opinion about the political system, how much you try to get involved in this system. At the end of the day, under this man's constitution, you're still three-fifths of a man. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Our persecutors are swifter than the eagles of the heaven. They pursued us upon the mountains. They laid wait for us in the wilderness. So this place, our people keep watching for a nation that's going to save them, all right? They're waiting for Esau, Edom, and his tricks, all right, to save you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Our people had this same notion 2,000 years ago when they said we have no king but Caesar. And you know what happened today. You know, yesterday, I ain't really got to go into it. I'm gonna get into this video. You already know the vice president is running for president after the previous president is gonna step down after this election, all right, in his presidency. So let's play this right quick. Yeah, a lot of you, this is from the Hopeful Elect. I think the Hopeful Elect part 3. All right, the vice president in a simple black community. Because this woman, she's not even an Israelite, man. All right, you are who your father is. And it's been known that when you go do her research, her family used to own a lot of plantations. Okay? So they can put any so-called brown face in front of you. They did it years ago with number 44. Okay? The guy that said change. And no change happened for you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. All right, that number 44 didn't do anything for you. All right, so I'm gonna play this right quick, get some precepts, and Lord, when you're edified.
Seeing people on Kamala hype train as if this woman hasn't been the vice president for the last 4 years, and our rent prices haven't skyrocketed, our inflation isn't through the roof, grocery prices ain't through the roof, and she hasn't been an advocate for anyone, not black, not white, not Indian, no American. She sat there, she's laughed, she's capped with her way through the last 4 years, and all of a sudden she's supposed to get our vote because she's black or black. Remember, she only claims to be black every 4 years when it's time to pay to you. Don't y'all get tired of that? Aren't you guys insulted by that? Especially, you know, holding on to catchphrases like, they not like us. And, you know, it reminds me of the whole hot sauce and bad swag shit. We're the simplest people. I say we, because I'm mostly talking about black people. We're easy managers. Like I say, no tangibles. Nothing's going to make the lives of black people easier or better. Right? Especially when we want to talk about this economy that they didn't send to the shitter. Meanwhile, that migrants to our cities and to our schools and giving them checks. Giving them checks. Putting them up in good hotels, putting them up in houses, giving them cars. And when people like us, we still struggle and beg and ask the government for everything. The government that she's a part of, y'all gonna get y'all funky asses on here and say y'all support Kamala because she's a better option than anybody else? First off, both sides are the same side of the same coin, so it really don't matter. but they can't physically run Biden, so they need somebody, a candidate that they can say, oh, there's a record turnout, and Kamala's just that, because they're going to use black women and gay black men, because y'all are the one people that are constantly rallying behind identity politics without being able to tell you one policy that this woman has come up with that's going to better y'all lives in any way, shape, or form, but simply because she looks like y'all going to vote for. Oh, get the bag, get the bag, y'all, the simple shit, y'all don't know straight black men that's into this shit, that's hype for Kamala. I know. So y'all are going to be easy paying to just like y'all always are, and then in 2-3 years when your rent is $1,000 more, you can barely afford to get 3 bags of groceries, you're going to say, what happened? It's all a game. No matter who's in office, they're going to push us there in the first place. But to my black people, I'm just saying, make this video to say, it ain't about voting, it's about stop letting them use us. Stop letting them pander to us to get out to these polls so that they can play a little political game. They can put what they want to put up in there anyway. But they don't have to use us as the passies for why they put these inept motherfuckers in there. Because that's what they gave a right and claim that, oh, the black turnout that put them in there. And then look at the fucking job he is. They can put that on our backs. Fuck, come on. Fuck the Democratic Party. If you want a more in-depth analysis on how I feel about this whole situation, check out my YT channel.
Hey, and Jake hit it right on the head. But you Negroes, I'm going to say Latinos and Native Americans voting. All right? Let's go to Jeremiah 4:22. Because this man is on point, because I just got off work like what, an hour ago. And one of my calls I had to go to, it was a Jake. It was an elderly Jake. I had to help him with something. So I'm in there for about a good hour and some change or whatever, trying to help him out, resolve a situation. And here it is. He got this on here. He got this Kamala Harris first remark since Biden steps down. Look at this woman, man. Simple, all right? And look at the guy that was her president, that still is the president. All right, now, I'm not gonna play that, but when you get into it, really, all right, her husband brought her onto the stage. You know, she started talking about how I know Donald Trump. I know his track record. So she's looking at it like she's the prosecutor, and she was a former prosecutor at Alameda County, all right, out there in Northern California, locking up a lot of you so-called black Hispanics and Native Americans, all right. And she made a smart-ass remark and said, I prosecuted a lot of people. And you can watch it for yourself. She said, I prosecuted a lot of people. And it has this smirk on her face. No, you prosecute a lot of blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And you Negroes will go vote for this woman. And like I said, I went to this man's house, and his woman is, you know, the black woman, man. Whether she's dark-skinned, brown-skinned, all right, red bone, high yellow, it's still the black woman at the end of the day. Clapping. Oh, she was like, oh, look at whatever Kamala Harris's husband is. Look at her, look at him and his black woman, just clapping and you know, cackling, man. Jeremiah 4:22, for my people is foolish. The God of the Bible said, you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are foolish. They have not known me, because when you read the scriptures, the one who you call Jesus, the one who you call Jesus, real name Yahweh Shai, right? Did he go cast a vote? All right? During the time of the Romans, he said, yeah, you know, Tiberius, man, you know, man, I'm going to vote for him. Hell no. Okay? He was doing the will of his father. All right? But a lot of our people of this world, and they rather go with the status quo as far as this voting system, which is not even in the Bible. All right, there's scriptures in Deuteronomy that tells you you're not supposed to put a man that's a man, let alone a woman, okay, let alone a woman over you. And this is going to cause all this feminism, all right? You're going to get all the black women, like the man said, you're going to get all the moles and all the black women to go vote for this woman, not even knowing her track record or history or what she stands for. All she's going to tell you is, all right, a woman shall, you can't tell a woman what to do with her body. We're going to create jobs. They kept, not like I said, I was at Jake's house. They was watching CNBC. All right, typical Democratic channel, okay? oh yeah, she created 15 million. The Biden-Harris administration created 15 million jobs. I haven't seen Kamala Harris do anything except for come to Atlanta. All right, the majority of the time she's been here for who knows what. For my people as foolish, they have not known me. You haven't known the Heavenly Father. You've known your oppressor. They are Sardis children. Sardis means stupid. And they have none understanding. You don't have any understanding of what to do when it comes to pleasing the Heavenly Father. You'd rather please a political candidate who doesn't give a damn about you than the Heavenly Father. That's a damn shame. They are wise to do evil. Yeah, voting. Putting trust in Kamala Harris or even DJ. But to do good, they have no knowledge. Yeah, you don't have no knowledge in the wisdom, knowledge, understanding of the scriptures, man. Ecclesiastes 10 and 6. Folly, which means foolishness, is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in low place. Yeah, this is foolishness, man. All of a sudden, you know, say it ain't so, Joe, had got to step down, and they're making it. He's like, well, I didn't want to step down. You know, now it's the vice president. Right, the one who was locking up all you Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans all the way out there in Alameda County, California. It's basically been known that this woman just slept her way to damn near being the president of the United States. That's how a lot of you women operate anyways in these companies. You sleep your way to the top. It wasn't because of what you know. It's how you. I ain't gonna say that, but anyways, there's a lot of folly going on. You got DJ, he got shot last week. Now he got the little you know how Nelly had that little band-aid strip over his eye back in the day. Now you got DJ, all right, with a band-aid strip over his right ear. It's a bunch of foolishness, man. And namely our people will believe this crap, man. Oh yeah, Kamala, man, she's, you know, yeah. Folly is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in low place. So there's a lot of foolishness going on. And for us in this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, we got to know what's really going on, man. Because this was really going on. Okay? Let me just get to this. I ain't going to make this too long. It doesn't matter who you vote for. They're all selected, man. At the end of the day. Now, this is from 2021. Complete list of 800 FEMA concentration camps. 2021, the road to hell. FEMA is the, now this lesson is based off the officer Shamak and this beautiful class that he did yesterday on July 21st about executive orders. Okay, see, a lot of people, they don't read into these executive orders, but they so quick to vote. You so quick to go to a poll and vote, and you don't even look up these orders that these presidents set up, and they're all in the same game. You don't, man, best believe DJ and the guy that's stepping down as president, they're buddies, okay? They're just playing you people, thinking they're against each other. Especially you so-called white people. You don't tread on me, Edomites. All right, you go through these little parts of Georgia, north of Atlanta. It's all Trump country. They're playing you people too. FEMA is an executive arm of the coming police state. Did you see that? Coming police state. It ain't gonna be no Supreme Court, all right? It's not gonna be no Constitution. It's gonna be a police state, and thus will head up all operations. The presidential executive orders already listed on the Federal Register are also part of the legal framework for this operation. The camps all have railroad facilities as well as roads leading to and from detention facilities. And the state of Georgia is known for a lot of railroads and trains. All right, keep that in mind for you people that live here. Many also have an airport nearby. The majority of the camps can house a population of 20,000 prisoners. Currently, the largest of these facilities is just outside of Fairbanks, Alaska. The Alaskan facility is a massive mental health facility and can hold approximately 2 million people because do you people not see what's going on Friday? They had IT outage that shut down a lot of hospitals, a lot of airports. This is what these elites are doing. This is what the prophets are telling you. They're coming about with their global reset. Do you people not pay attention to the World Economic Forum and Klaus Schwab and what he's saying and how to read between the lines? doesn't matter what your vote is going towards, man. It's all going to you leading up in these detention centers, with the biggest one being Alaska. But the state of Georgia has the most. Now let's review the justification for any actions taken. Executive orders associated with FEMA that would suspend Constitution and the Bill of Rights. These executive orders have been on record for nearly 30 years. All right, going on, almost 33, 34 years, according to this, and could be enacted by the stroke of a presidential pen. So, hey, even if this woman do get in, you see how women act when they get in power, man. All right, you see these local judges in your local city, especially the black woman, man. All right, you think that this woman is a black woman when she's really an Elamite, which is a so-called East Indian, because you are who your father is. Now, her mother's a so-called black woman, but her father is an Elamite, a so-called East Indian. So she's not a black woman. She's not an American Negro woman. She's not from the tribe of Judah. Okay? They're not going to put a woman from the tribe of Judah or any of the 12 tribes of Israel into the White House. All right? They're fooling you people. You know, how like they did with Barack Obama and that weak-ass jump shot he had, and you Negroes went to go vote for this guy. He didn't do anything for you. Then you went to go vote for the guy who's leaving the office because he's too sleepy and old. If you don't vote for me, you ain't black. And where did that get you? Got you kicked out of your home due to inflation. All right? So any day now, any president that's in there, it might not be a presidential election, man. Hey, these people that's voting for DJ, they mad. They live it right now. They mad. All right? It says on December 6th and January 6th, President DJ word shook the world. Watch the video below. So, I mean, this guy might get back in here. You know, the Elamite woman get back in here. But let's look at these executive orders. Now, you voting for so-called freedom of democracy. This is basically what you're voting for. Executive Order 10990 allows the government to take over all modes of transportation and control of highway and seaports, because they're going to use them tanks to run through Interstate 75, 85, 20, all right, Interstate 10, 95, 75, whatever the case may be. Executive Order 10995 allows the government to seize and control the communication media. Executive Order 10997 allows the government to take over all electrical power, gas, petroleum, fuels, and minerals. So basically, they're just shutting everything down. This is what you people are voting for. You're voting for your downfall. Executive Order 10998 allows the government to seize all means of transportation, including personal cars. So your personal cars are going to get taken out the way. Trucks or vehicles of any kind. And this is when they declare martial law. And total control over all highways, seaports, and waterways. Let's get this precept right quick. Second Ezra 15 and verse 17, straight to the point. Let's start at verse 14. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein. Woe means destruction. For the sword and the destruction draw nigh, and one people shall stand up and fight against another, and swords in their hands. There's going to be racial tension, no doubt, but there's going to be political tension. All right, man, this is me speaking as a man. All these women out here that was voting for DJ, and they see Kamala running, they might switch, and their husband might be voting for DJ. That's gonna cause confusion, man. That's gonna cause division. That's what we want. We want to see widespread division, because that means our salvation is nearer than when we believe, and we're close to get up out of here. Best believe we need Yahweh Shah to come back ASAP. Well, you got a woman that looks like a so-called black woman that's gonna be in office. Do you know how much hell that's gonna be if she gets up in there? And it's going to be hell if DJ gets up in there, because DJ said he's going to bring the guillotine back. All right? Verse 16, for there shall be sedition among men, the act of going against the government, all right, which people are going to do now. People have been doing it. They've been saying, let's go Brandon. That's an act of sedition, man. In any other country, you would have got put to death, man, talking about F your president. Now that they said F Joe Biden, now they want to let's go Brandon. That's an act of sedition, man. and invading one another, they shall not regard their kings nor princes. They don't, these people don't give a damn about these elected officials, man. And it's going to come down to it when there's a lack of bread out here. When people can't eat, when people can't go to Starbucks for their coffee, they can't go to Chick-fil-A to get that demonic chicken sandwich, all right? They can't go to Kroger to get their groceries. It's going to be widespread sedition out here. Then these people are going to know that they effed up, man. That voting thing, it didn't work out. And the course of their actions shall stand in their power. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. And that's what they're doing with these executive orders. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. When they take away your personal car, what does that mean? You're going to be on foot. All right. Executive Order 10998 allows the government to seize all means of transportation, including personal cars, trucks, or vehicles of any kind, and total control over all highways, seaports, and waterways. Executive Order 10999 allows the government to take over all food resources and farms. That's why you see these different farms getting burnt down, plants getting burned down. They're making a way for Executive Order 10999 to come into pass. So what are they going to do? They're going to say, hey, you gotta take this device. Matter of fact, let's get it. You got to take this device. I might do a part two on this. I don't want to make it too long. All right. I was done with that Jeremiah 4 and 22. Revelation 13 and 16. For all you non-believers of the mark of the beast, you're sadly mistaken, man. You can keep chopping and screwing the scriptures to fit your narrative, but all right, when you put the scriptures up against this man's legislation and the news articles, it lines up to Revelation 13 and 16. Revelation 13 and 16, and he calls up all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, that charagma, that digital all, that same brain chip that they're putting into patients so they can walk again, so they can see again. That's that same chip that they're going to be using to control the masses when they take away everything. You shall own nothing and be happy, as the World Economic Forum tells you. So they're going to strip you of all your rights, and they're going to say, hey, look, you got to go down to your local Superdome or local Mercedes-Benz Stadium, because basically these big-ass sporting events are going to turn into concentration camps, man. All right, when you go down to Atlanta and you see the Mercedes-Benz Stadium, that's the biggest concentration camp out of Georgia, man. Verse 17, and that no man might buy or sell, say he had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. So you can't buy or sell. Basically, they make it to where you can't do anything without this brain implant, this C-hip. All right. So that's what it's leading to. All these executive orders are leading to Revelation 13 and 16. And that's what your vote is going towards. More oppression. And you Native Americans, you sure as hell shouldn't be voting, man. What are you voting for? 4 more years on a reservation? Executive Order 11001. Excuse me, 11000 allows the government to mobilize civilians and into work brigades under government supervision. Yeah, they're going to have your ass in a concentration camp. Okay? Hey, you so-called white people, you gonna be in there with Pookie from Zone 6 out of Atlanta. Here it is, your ass live in Canton, Georgia. All right, don't tread on me. You gonna be in the same concentration camp with Pookie from Zone 6, looking stupid. Executive Order 11001 allows the government to take over all health, education, and welfare functions. That's why they got. That's why Esau with the elites is trying to give the World Health Organization authority, all right, over health concerns. Executive Order 11002 designates the Postmaster General to operate national registration of all persons. Executive Order 11003 allows the government to take over all airports and aircraft, including commercial aircraft. And you don't see what happened on Friday of last week? So what was Friday? Sunday was the 21st. The 19th. You don't see what happened on the 19th when there's an IT outage. That's giving them license to take over the airports and the aircraft. You people are starting waking up, especially you Negroes, because y'all gloating and jumping up and down for this woman. And hey, if it's her or if it's the guy who used to be in there, Make America Great, number 45, they're gonna exact this quick, man. All right. Executive Order 11004 allows the Housing and Finance Authority to relocate communities, build new housing with public funds, designate areas to be abandoned, and establish new locations for populations. That's why they tearing down all these cities. You people riding in these cities, and they're going to make these 15-minute cities. You people all be out here riding, order out of chaos, and they're going to put these people in these 15-minute cities. Say, hey, we need to put these people in a 15-minute radius so we can watch them. That's what it's leading to. You're basically voting for your Uncle Sam to spy on you and put you in a 15-minute city. Executive Order 11005 allows the government to take over railroads, because they're going to send your ass to a concentration camp through a railroad, inland waterways, and public storage facilities. And I'm going to just stop right there. I'm going to get some more. This is just, I don't want to go too much. But this is what you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans vote for, man. That's why we say these. That's why we read these scriptures. Micah 2 and 10. Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest. Voting is not going to lead into eternal life. Voting is not going to lead into you being free from oppression and taxation and slavery. America is not your rest. So-called Black, Hispanic, and Native American man, woman, and child. Don't believe the hype of these politicians, man. Because basically, all these executive orders been set up 30 years ago. So it doesn't matter who you vote for. It's all leading up to your demise. Because it is polluted, it shall destroy you. Yeah, all this legislation that Esau Edom, the so-called white man, is putting up, it's all to destroy you. So why in the hell you vote for this man? Even with a sore destruction. So I'm going to just leave that on net. Lord, when I can make a part two, I can go through more orders, but our people are voting for oppression. Let's get this one more, and I think it's Psalms 62 and 10. That's all you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans to vote for. We're telling you to come back to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. I'm sure you heard of the Hebrew Israelites, those guys on the street corners. That's what we're telling you. All right? We're telling you, all right, what's going on before it's about to happen. Martial law is about to be declared. And all these executive orders that I read from this lesson, Lord, when I can get to some more, it's going to lead to your demise if you don't trust in the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son. Psalm 62 and 10, trust not in oppression. That's what our people are voting for. You're voting because you women can abort your baby, or you're voting for some type of change in groceries. Hey, inflation is going to lead to hyperinflation. It's not a damn thing that either Kamala or DJ can do for you Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, and basically you Americans as a whole. All right? Trust not in oppression, and become not vain in robbery. If riches increase, set not your heart upon them. So, Lord, when I was edifying, Lord, when I can do another part. All right, this is part 17, the hope for your Jacob's trouble. And hey, let's get this one in Jeremiah 30, because this is where it might lead to. Lord willing, man. All right, Jeremiah 30 and 7. This is the hopeful year of Jacob's trouble. And we've seen a lot of stuff move through the Spirit. Jeremiah, especially in the month of July. July has been hot. Jeremiah 30 and 7. Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. Now, Jacob's name was changed to Israel. And he had 12 sons, which represent you so-called Blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, and yes, you Israelites who might look like the heathen, because we got a lot of Israelites that look like so-called white people, man. There's a lot of Israelites that look like so-called Arabs, look like so-called Africans, look like so-called Pacific Islanders, look like so-called Japanese, so-called Chinese. It's time for you to get the word right now, especially you ones who live in America. Okay, you see them guys in the street corners, namely Great Millstone, who's preaching prophecy, who's telling you about the mark of the beast, who's telling you about World War III, who's telling you about civil war and civil unrest. Hey, you Israelite foreigners, man, you better get with this word, man. Because Jacob's trouble is about to unleash, man. Doesn't matter who you vote for, you're basically voting for your oppression. But he shall be saved out of it. He is talking about the elect, because when you read the Bible, All right, from the Old Testament, even to the New Testament, it talks about the Lord's chosen, his Lord's elect. All right, so Lord willing, we're part of that number. But first and foremost, we got to warn the people what's going on. Don't believe the hype, all right, of these people, man. All right, don't get caught up in these words. They're just saying stuff so they can get your vote and put four more years of hell on you. Don't believe, you know, the narrative, man. Don't believe the hype. So with that, I want to say shalom.